Hey guys, it's Alex here from Resident Entertainment, also known as the girl with the woohoo tattoo. I've gone with the 1920s sort of Gatsby theme today to take you through the new Sims 4 Vintage Glamour Stuff Pack. Now, I've already gone ahead and checked out the pack, and I've created a family and updated one of the apartments just so that you can have a quick look and get an idea of whether this pack is for you. I just showed you all the female adult wear, which is beautiful. I'm so glad they included suspenders for the gentlemen because I couldn't find them to begin with. I've also added some paisley socks there for, you know, comfort. There's a nice little waistcoat number and of course the all popular Hugh Hefner. All these designs are obviously available in different colours, but just to save time I've just included some basic ones today. Now this is Madeline, she's going to be my little monster because obviously she's going to be getting her hands in all the makeup. And this is just this is the dress that's included for the children and I just think it's so cute, I would totally wear that. There's heaps of different colours as well, so I'll just flick through some of them now just so you can have a look. Personally I really like the teal one, yeah, that's so pretty, it's very mermaid, it's very me, but I think she suits the blue one. Here's one of the hairstyles for the kids, and it's got a really cute little clip, but you can't change the colour of the clip, which really upset me, but, you know, I'm not that bothered about it. Just would have been nice to have some different colours to, you know, match outfits. Anyway, let's go ahead and check out the apartment that I've put together for this family. So this family is Carolyn, Jamal and Madeline, and they are in this amazing apartment. I liked this one because it almost had that retro feel to begin with, and it's very luxurious. So I'm just going to give you a quick tour. Oh, side note, the camera in this apartment hates me, so I'm sorry if there's any jumpy camera work. So this is the bottom floor in their apartment. As you can see, I've already decked it out. I've given them a bit of a wine cellar because, you know, they're fancy, they're glamorous, they're vintage. We'll leave that for the butler. But this is the bottom floor, so this is how I left them. Yeah, let's get it started. Wake them up. So these guys are super rich, you know, he's going to be a politician, she's going to be like a stay-at-home mum, music, arty, that kind of thing. I sort of use the goths to sort of style them on because, you know, they're our favourite fancy pants. Oh, see, this is what I mean, the camera just hates me. There we go. So this is the living room. I love the piano in the side. That was originally white. I changed it to black for the theme. I went with the black and gold sort of Gatsby Art Deco sort of style. And I love the jazz bit. That was so cool. I'm a big jazz person myself. And it's really funny. I do love this lamp. And it's hilarious because I went on a cruise this year, which was like a 1920s Gatsby themed one. And they had a lamp exactly like that. So you can see I've gone with the splashes of yellow or gold to sort of accentuate that theme. But I'll take you upstairs. I don't know where she's gone, probably getting her hands in the makeup already. Just so that you can have a look and see how I remodeled this one just to match the theme. Of course we had to put the hot tub out on the porch there, the balcony. Oh, yes, and the wonderful couch. I love this couch. I love that everything sort of matches. So upstairs now, this is where the bedrooms are. I don't know where he's going, but I moved a couple of things around. As you can see, we've got that cool little lion dog Chinese. I like that it sort of has that Asian sort of influence to fit in with the city living stuff. I moved the vanity table outside just so that we can get a better view with that one. And then, yeah, I didn't really change much in the bathroom, but this is the master bedroom. Just have a look at the awesome... Hang on, I'll put the walls up. The wallpaper, as you move, it changes. It's so cool. Yep, I love the wallpapers. They're so detailed. The textures are just incredible. We've got some new mirrors there, the chair. That's one of the beds. And of course the painting that's there. But I'll go into the little girl's room so you can have a bit of a quick look and see how I use the different colours. So that's the second bed that's included. And I use some kid stuff in there just to make it a little bit girly. And I love those fluffy rugs. They're like my new favourite thing. Alright, so I have to apologise for this bit. I had a bit of a glitch with the butler. Here he is. I'm going to just say hello because Jamal's such a nice guy. For some reason, the butler is never coming back. He's gone. I'm going to have to reset SIM or something on him, but I can't get him. But I'm just going to demonstrate with this video of how you can annoy them with the bell. So what I'm going to get him to do is just run some errands. You can take a look at the pie menu of all the things that he can do. Of course, you need to have a bed and a separate room for him so that he can lock his room and have his... There he is. I like his hairstyle. What a rad dude. So yeah, basically he can have his own space and while he's looking after the family. So I'm going to get Carolyn to annoy him a little bit, and we're actually about to throw a party. So I'm going to get him to entertain the guests, answer the door. There's the bell. So basically, yeah, you ring the bell, the butler does the things. So it's pretty cool. Goes ringing the bell. And one more time. What can we do here? Yeah, let's cook the party meal. Let's do that. And thank you, Caroline. So yeah, the butler's a really cool little thing. I think you can also look after kids and stuff as well. You know what? Fire in, you can tell them to stop doing things. Visitors, okay, cool. And then, yep. Let's get him to play piano. Alright, cool. And ready. Oh, there's a bit of a glitch there. Nah, it still worked. Awesome. Alrighty, so let's start this dinner party. Let's get it rolling. He's already happy cooking. Sorry, Steph, you just got a freebie there. So we'll take it to the night, and we're going to enjoy a bit of a drink at the pool. So the World Globe Bar is probably one of my favourite items here. I mean, I am obsessed with travel myself, so this was really cool. The fact you can hide your booze in it is really awesome. And Carolyn's just going to pour herself a little sniff to start the night off. I love that gown. It's so pretty. And of course, we're going to get our little Tara to come down and have a bit of a play. Just because, you know, she's fun. She likes to get her hands into things. Apparently there's also an Easter egg with this globe bar. So if anyone has seen that, write it down in the comments. I want to see how smart you guys are. This is probably one of my favourite things. She's just going to... Do it. Do the thing. Whoops. Crash. Yeah, so that's probably like one of my favourite things in the whole game. Now, I'm pretty sure the party's about to get started, so we should definitely look at getting Carolyn ready for that. Let's take her upstairs and put some makeup on. So I was really impressed with the vanity table. There is so much to choose from, different styles, and it really does only last that night. So, you know, you don't have to worry about going in and actually changing it all. And it gives a cool little feature as well, cool little animations. So I'm just going to choose one here. I think it was the... I don't know. That one do. And I'm just going to show you the animations of what it looks like when they're actually getting ready. Let me put the walls up so it looks a bit better. So these are the really cool animations. So obviously, she's going to put a lot of makeup on. Get that highlighter on, girl. And then when it's all finished, it actually does, you can pretty much see it change. I love the Powerpuff, it's so cute. So yeah, now you can see that her makeup is lighter. So it was a real heavy sort of dark lip before, but now it's sort of gone to a more natural tone. And I just think that's so cool. All right, where's our little monster? Come see what you can do. Here we go. Do your worst, Missy. check. More eyeliner. That's how you do it. Check. Bit of that. Ah, voila. And that's what I call sexy. Let's have a look at this. You're going to go swim in the pool. Alright, good. That's exactly what you want to do. After you put your makeup on, go for a swim. Oh, look at you, Madeline. You're so gorgeous. That is just gorgeous. And that's pretty much it. Obviously, I'll leave the rest up to you. You guys can have a look. And, have fun exploring The Sims 4 Vintage Glamour stuff.